going to be doing my first DIY video on a little cat cubbyhole hiding spot. First, you'll need a bucket, box, a box can be any size, tape, scissors, and an unsharpened pencil. First, you'll want to lay out your blanket and place your box in the middle. Then, I'm going to be making my low, so I'm going to show you how to do that. And what I mean by low, I mean my box isn't going to be like high, it's going to be like that pretty much. So, because she likes to crawl and stuff. She's already looking at the box. Very interested.
Cardboard is not for eating, Lexi.
Okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to place a piece of tape right here. Next, I want to remove your box, see your tape, see off. It's probably easier to take your box and stick your leg, make your leg pull it up, and then take a pencil and stick it to the tape and pull it way down. There we go. And now pull up your box. See how what Lexi thinks of it. Lexi, what did I just say? My board is not for eating. You also want to tape the bottom of your pencil to your cardboard. And you're wondering why my box is moving. That's why. Look at pink tongue. If you don't want your cat to chew on it like this, you may want to little hang-offs like this. But if you honestly don't care, then your cat chew. And have fun, I guess. You may definitely want to stick tape under with the tape on top, so your cat doesn't get stuck on the tape. Oh, sure. You may want to put another sheet of tape on this, so that your cat also doesn't get stuck on the tape. Honestly, you can put as much tape on these as you like, but what you really want to do is make sure that there's nothing sticky, like there's a sticky spot. Okay, so I'm going to put a piece of tape over it so it doesn't stick. And then, looks like it's all good here. Yep, we're all good up here. I'm just going to cover this, and then I'll show you the next step. Next, you want to take your blanket and cover your box. And if you're a perfectionist like me, like how it's not going even, don't worry about it, trust me, your cat will not care. Because they love it anyway. So wait, Kiki. Oh, that's how you cover your blanket. You're gonna put tape to keep the blanket on to your box. When you're done covering your box, it will most likely look like this, or something similar. You can leave it like this, and it'll have like multiple entrances. Like, you can see it's kind of dark in there. But, there, you have two entrances, or you can move this upward. So there's only one entrance. One exit. You don't have to take this down if you're doing the one exit, because if you want to change it, you can only just throw it down, and bam, your cat can get in both ways. But I want to thank you guys for watching. This is going to be used, I'm pretty sure, because she loves her boxes. I plan on doing many more of DIYs. I already have 3 more plans. I'm not sure when we're doing. But I also want to apologize for not posting as much, because I have been really busy at school. But I plan on being able to post this weekend. I'm going to do a small clip of Lexi using the robot.